الحمد لله الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده على من لا نبي بعده ولا أمة بعد أمته ولا كتاب بعد كتابه أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير صدق الله العظيم. Respected viewers, welcome back to our program Rays of Light, where we look at different ayats, different themes from the Holy Quran. In the ayat which I've recited is a very famous ayat of the Holy Quran, which is part of the last two verses of Surah Baqarah. And indeed, these are very significant verses. We know that the entire Quran comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, تَنْزِيلٌ مِّنْ حَكِيمٍ حَمِيدٍ. It is revealed by the one who is Hakim and Hamid, the one who is full of praise, and the one who is full of wisdom. بَلْ هُوَ قُرْآنٌ مَجِيدٌ. It is a Quran Majid, which comes from the protected tablets. But if there has to be also an added dimension, in some way we could call it a cosmic verse, verse that is from heaven, then this ayat and the last two verses of Surah Baqarah will fit that bill. Because these two verses were revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the occasion of Mi'raj. It was revealed in heavens. And it is very significant. It comes in a hadith that Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam one day was sitting with our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasalam, and he said, O Prophet of Almighty Allah, today a door of heaven has been opened that has never been opened before. And angels have come out of that door that have never been come out before. And they are coming down with a verse that has never been revealed before to any other nation but to the nation of your ummah. And they are coming down with two verses and two revelations. One is Surah Fatiha, and one is the last two verses of Surah Baqarah. It has a very amazing background and a very amazing meaning. Let me give you a little bit of the background. In the verses, in the verse preceding the last two verses, comes an ayat, وَإِن تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبْكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. If you reveal something with your bodily parts and organs of your body, you do any action. Or if you conceal it, Allah will take account of those deeds. So when this ayat was revealed, Sahaba came to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam greatly perturbed. O Prophet of Almighty Allah, we could understand that we will be accountable for deeds that we do. But this ayat gives an impression that we are going to be accountable even for our thoughts. O tukhfuhu, what you conceal, Allah will take into account that also. Ya Rasulullah, that is very difficult for us. We don't have control over our thoughts. Sometimes your thoughts go into different directions. And if this is going to be the case, we will find it very difficult to account. Ya Rasulullah, Ya Allah, Ya Rasulullah, tell Allah this is very difficult for us. So our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood what the meaning of the verse was. It was not that Allah will take into account about thoughts that are random, that comes involuntarily. Allah won't take into account those thoughts. But Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam told them, O my companions, when Allah's commands come, then even if you find it difficult, the first impulsive reaction should be, Oh Allah, even if it is difficult, we will try our utmost to comply with those commands. Sahaba heard this from Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They said, Ya Rasulullah, we submit, we accept. And Allah then in the first of those two last verses of Surah Baqarah praised them. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون. The Rasul and the Malaika. And Allah then aids the believers. They bring iman upon what Allah has revealed. And they bring iman upon كُلٌّ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ upon Allah, Malaika, the angels and the prophets. لَا نُفَرِّقُ بَيْنَ أَحَدٍ مِّن رُسُولِهِ. They don't make no distinction between the prophets. There are other groups and other faith groups that make distinction. We accept some prophets and don't accept other prophets. This ummah, alhamdulillah, it accepts all the messengers of Allah. Do not make a distinction in terms of iman. وَقَالُوا, and they say, سَمِعْنَا وَعَطَعْنَا, we have heard, and oh Allah, we will obey. غُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرُ. Oh Allah, forgive us for our shortcomings in terms of submitting and trying to practice upon your commands. And to you is our return where we will be held accountable. This ayat, سَمِعْنَا وَعَطَعْنَا, is such an amazing verse. It is the gist of Islam, submission to the will of Allah. In Surah Nisa, Allah Ta'ala says, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ دِينًا مِّمَّنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ. Whose deen is better than the one who submits his will to Allah. Now when they did that, they submitted. And we read the سَمِعْنَا وَعَطَعْنَا, the imams read it after salat and they complete their dua with it. It has great significance. Then the next verse then clarified the matter. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah will never impose upon you a responsibility or a burden which is beyond you to carry out. And thoughts that come into your mind and your heart without you bringing it in, random thoughts. And sometimes those thoughts are not very noble. It could be wrong. But you did not bring it in. It just came up. Allah will not hold you accountable. You are not responsible for that. And it is beyond you. So Allah Ta'ala says, لا يكلف الله. Allah will never impose upon you a responsibility which is beyond you to carry out. لها ما كسبت وعليها. For you is what you have done. And here there is an emphasis upon that. For you is what you have done, your amal. Allah will take it into account. Yes, if a thought comes and you enjoy the thought and you then continue that trend of thought, that Allah will hold you accountable. But if a thought comes without you, you know, bringing it in, Allah will not hold you accountable. But Allah loved what the Sahaba said, سَمِعْنَا وَعَطَعْنَا, we have heard and we will obey. Then of course, the last two verses then concludes with this dua, which many of us will know. رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا إِن نَسِينَا أَوْ أَخْطَأْنَا. Oh Allah, do not hold us and hold us accountable for that which we have forgotten or that which we have done by mistake. Oh Allah, do not hold us accountable for our shortcomings. Forgive us, Ya Allah. رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا إِن رَبَّنَا وَلَا تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْنَا. Oh Allah, do not impose upon us a burden that is beyond us to carry out. For the Bani Israel, many of the ahkam were very difficult. Allah has made it relatively easy for us in this ummah. إن ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إسرا كما ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا والله forgive us and have mercy upon us وارحمنا واعف عنا واغفر لنا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين and help us against those who are disbelievers and who are our enemies. And that's how this last verse of Surah Baqarah ends in this beautiful manner. Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in a hadith which I will conclude, whoever reads these last two verses of Surah Baqarah at night, it will suffice for him. Allah will suffice and care for him. In one riwayat, whoever reads these last two verses, after reading Isha and Fajr wa Jamaat, he will get the reward of the entire night's ibadat. Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Umar radiallahu ta'ala used to say, only a person who does not have intellect will go to sleep without reading these two verses before he sleeps. And when I have given a small background with regard to it, we can understand why it is so. May Allah give us the tawfiq of understanding. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.